Hello everyone. As you know, numbers play an important role in our lives. Almost all the things we do involve numbers and mathematics. I hope by now we all know what are rational and irrational numbers. Let's quickly take a recap about them. In the previous session, we have learned about the rational and irrational numbers. A rational number is one that can be written in the form of ratio p by q of two integers, a numerator p and a non-zero denominator q. For example, 1 divided by 2. Here, p is equal to 1 and q is equal to 2. Next example, 7. It can be written as 7 divided by 1, where p is equal to 7 and q is equal to 1. Now, an irrational number is the opposite one that cannot be written as a ratio of two integers. For example, root 6 is equal to 2.4494 and so on. Next, we have root 5 is equal to 2.2360 and so on. So, all these are irrational numbers. All these are a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. That is, a decimal number that never ends. The rational and irrational numbers together form the real numbers. In this session, we are going to learn about the mathematical operation on these real numbers. Now, we came to know what exactly real numbers are. But what are these mathematical operations? So, the four basic mathematical operations are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Let's see what happens if we add two rational numbers. Let's take an example, 0.24 plus 0.60, which equals to 0.84, which means we can write 0.84 in the form of p by q, that is 84 divided by 100, which gives solution as 21 divided by 25. Here we are getting numerator and denominator as an integers. Now let's take the other example, root 9 divided by root 4 plus root 4 divided by root 16, which equals to root 9 will be 3 divided by root 4 is 2 plus root 4 is 2 divided by root 16 is 4, is equal to the LCM of 2 and 4 will be 4, 6 plus 2 is equal to 8 divided by 4, which equals to 2. So here again we can write it in the form of p divided by q, that is 2 divided by 1. So 2 is equal to p and 1 is equal to q. Next example, we are getting again in the form of p by q, that is 49 divided by 20. Therefore, these are all rational numbers as we are getting the solution in the form of p by q. Now we can here see that when we add two rational numbers, we will get a rational number only. This is the first property of addition of rational numbers. Let's move to the next case. When we have irrational numbers, root 3 plus minus root 3, we get a solution equal to root 3 plus minus will be minus root 3 equal to 0. That is, we can write it as 0 divided by 1, which is the form of p by q. Hence, it is a rational number. Let's take another example, 5 root 13 plus 2 root 13, we get 7 root 13 equal to 7 into the value of root 13 is 3.6055 and so on is equal to 25.2388 and so on. Next example. So here, as we are getting non-terminating and non-recurring decimal, hence, it is an irrational number. Thus, we can conclude that when we add two irrational numbers, the result can be a rational or an irrational number. Now, let's see what we get if we add rational number with an irrational number. So here, when we add root 2, which is an irrational number, 4, which is a rational number, then we get the value of root 2 is equal to 1.4142 and so on. Plus 4. This will give us 5.4142 and so on. that is a non-terminating and non-recurring decimal, which is an irrational number. Similarly, let's take another example, root 13, which is an irrational number, plus root 4, which is a rational number. We get the value of root 13 is equal to 3.6055 and so on, plus root 4 is 2, which will give us 5.6055 and so on. That is again a non-terminating and non-recurring decimal, which is an irrational number. Similarly, we can see in other examples, we are getting solution as an irrational numbers. Hence, the addition of a rational number and an irrational number is always irrational. So this is our third property of rational numbers. Okay friends, this was for addition of real numbers. The same results are obtained when we do the subtraction of real numbers. Why don't you guys try few of these subtractions of real numbers and let us know the answers, and also let us know that does these properties really hold true for subtraction too? Well, you can see here this property hold true for subtraction too. So what we have learned in this session, if we add two rational numbers, then we will get a rational number only. Next, if we add two irrational numbers, then the result can be a rational or an irrational number. And at last, we have seen if we add a rational number and irrational number, then we will get a irrational number. And this property holds true for subtraction too. So friends, in the next session, we are going to learn about remaining properties, and also we are going to see how to simplify the expressions and how to rationalize the denominator. I hope you guys have enjoyed the session. Don't forget to hit the like button and comment down if you have any queries.